What is up, Benchwarmers? And we are here for the final NFC South NFL 2020 season prediction with the last place Carolina Panthers, who they got a better roster than what you might think on offense. Defense is depleted pretty much. They're going to need a little bit to rebuild. But the situation with this year, training camp might be happening July 28th. I think that was up in the air until yesterday or today. So I think it's okay now. But, you know, it's just another thing, another reason why I think the Packers are going to be in a pretty good situation. But I think I'll make a video about that separately. But with the Panthers, they got Teddy Bridgewater, they got Robbie Anderson, they got Curtis Samuel, they got DJ Moore, and they got Christian McCaffrey on offense. They lost Greg Olsen, but he was pretty much old, and he went to Seattle. They lost Luke Kuechly, which is the biggest loss that they had. They got Matt Rhule as a new head coach. So everybody is in a new system, and that is why they are here, is because the year that they decided to do all this with a new system and all these new players, very bad year, but it could do well for them in the draft next year. They're probably not going to do that well this year because of the way the offseason was. Nobody's really been able to practice. They'll have a month of practice, but no preseason, so don't expect rookies to do anything for half the season. So, that's kind of my take on this, is the Panthers, while they'd be probably good any other year, because there's been virtually no offseason, there's going to be no preseason for them to practice and get it kind of chemistry, just training camp. I think they're doing expanded practice squads and making it easier to transfer to from practice squad to regular 53-man. So, there's that. But I think the Panthers should be good, but they won't because of that. So, they're in last place solely for that reason. Their offense, I think, could compete with the best of them. I mean, Bridgewater is a solid quarterback. He was going to be really good for the Vikings before he obliterated his knee in practice, and he looked really good for the Saints. Now, the Saints, they also had a really good offense, but, you know, he's got three very solid receivers. He's got that downfield threat in Robbie Anderson. Curtis Samuel, DJ Moore was looking really good last year too. And he's obviously got Christian McCaffrey. That offense is not going to be anything to scoff at. But it's a matter of how are they going to do in Matt Rhule's new system with virtually no practice. 1 month of practice, that's all they get. I don't know if it's enough time to prepare. But that being said, let's get into the first 4 weeks. Now, some of these are a little surprising. Raiders, not very surprising. Actually, only one of them is really surprising, and that's week 4. But Raiders, I think you're going to beat them. This one could go either way. I think I might lean towards the Raiders winning a little bit more now, knowing that there's going to be no preseason. But at the same time, they got some rookies that they're kind of going to be depending on as well. I think the Raiders' defense is better, but Christian McCaffrey alone, I think, is going to be enough to beat the Raiders' defense, so I'm just going to say Panthers for that. I think they got, like, their offense, it'll take a little bit to click, but I still think it'll be enough to take on teams like the Raiders. Buccaneers, they got a defense that could hold it. They kind of did last year a little bit on a Thursday night game. But their offense might be a close game because I don't think the Buccaneers offense going to quite have it together yet for the same reason, because Tom Brady's in the new system. He's on a whole other, it's a whole new ball game for him for the first time in his career. And this is going to be kind of a winning in the trenches kind of game. And that's why I give the Buccaneers the edge, because their trenches are, I don't know where I'm going with this analogy, but I'll say that their trenches are dug deeper than the Panthers' trenches, so it's an advantage. I don't know. I don't know what kind of analogy I would want to go. Just hit my mic, so that was probably really loud. So, next, week 3, Chargers, all-around better team. other than running back, but they still got Austin Eckler, who, nothing to scoff at. He's really good. I loved him in fantasy last year, that's for sure. I had both him and McCaffrey. Melvin Gordon took snaps away from him, so that kind of made them a little bit worse to me. But Tyrod Taylor's an upgrade from Phillip Rivers, last year's version of Phillip Rivers. And I just think their defense is that much, it's way better than the Panthers. And their offense is a little bit more put together, and they have the same coach. Their only big difference is quarterback, which is a big difference, but they also have team chemistry all around, basically. And then they're going to beat the Cardinals. This is the surprise. I would probably change it to the Cardinals, honestly. But I'm not going to. I'm going to keep it the way it is. So that's it. Next four. Keep it moving. Also kind of surprising. Beating the Falcons. Corona. They're going to beat the Falcons. Falcons are going to underperform kind of like they did this past year. They don't have that much time for practice, so going to be a close game. Pretty brief explanation. Same thing for the Bears. Close game. One in the trenches, but their defense is way, way better than the Panthers. I don't think it's going to matter who's going to be playing quarterback for the Bears, so long as they're just a game manager. And if Matt Nagy actually uses running backs, which I think he will. I think he'll actually use running backs this year. Panthers, biggest surprise, beating the Saints. I think it's just division games. They're played differently. Like, I could say it for the Falcons, too, but I think the Panthers might catch the Saints a little off guard here because, I mean, they have three wins. They're 3-3 before this season. They're 500, so I guess that's something to kind of look out for. But I don't know. I just don't. I'll just say it's hard to sweep a division opponent, even if they're really bad. So Panthers taking the first one. Falcons taking the second one. Same reason. Division rivals are they just play harder when it's division. Thursday night football. I think the Falcons, you know, they want their revenge. So they're gonna take this one. Next four. So their only win is against the Bucks. I think Panthers offense, you know, gets a little bit more together, and because of that, you know, they're going to have to pay attention more to the passing game than more than just Christian McCaffrey for the defense, and I still think this will be early enough to catch the Buccaneers off guard. That second week, the first versus the Buccaneers, they kind of caught you off guard because their defense has been together for a while, at least a year under the defensive coordinator, so they kind of know what they're doing, so they catch you off guard there. You catch them off guard here because your offense is finally starting to get it, and you can keep their offense off the field. But then you're going to, before that, you lose to the Chiefs. That should be self-explanatory. They're the Chiefs. But then you're going to lose to the Lions. Lions are going to be a little worse now that I think about it a little more. I heard something about Swift saying he's kind of talking smack to Kerryon Johnson, saying he's taking that starting spot. So that could mean trouble. Who knows? Maybe they'll bring them to being competitive. But I'm going to say the Lions win this just if Stafford's healthy. If everyone's healthy, the Lions are a better team. So Lions take that one. Vikings, I think this one could actually go either way. Because week 12, I think teams finally get where they want to get to. They got the system. And Vikings defense, even after everybody they lost, it's better than the Panthers defense. Dalvin Cook versus Christian McCaffrey, that's going to be fun to watch. That's going to be one I hope I can watch. And I'm hoping the Panthers win. I'm hoping the Panthers win both of those. I want them to beat everybody in the North except for the Packers. But I think the Vikings are going to win. That it's kind of the same thing. They don't have Stephon Diggs, but their offense is still... This one's a toss-up to me, but I could see the Panthers winning this one. So then you get the bye week, week 13, and then the final four. Sorry about that, Panthers fans, but 6-10. Like I said, your team is better on paper just because of your offense, but because of the situation that this offseason has put you in, it's going to be a little worse. So the Broncos, you're going to beat them. I think the Broncos could definitely beat you, but you might catch them off guard here, especially coming off of a bye week where you have a lot of time to prep. You're going to lose to the Packers. They're a better team. They beat you last time, and your defense is worse this time. Your offense is a little better. You got a better quarterback, but maybe their defense is even better in year three of Pettine's defense. Who knows? You're going to lose to the Redskins. Kind of a shocking one, but you're already out. You're kind of going for draft. Like, you're not tanking, but you don't care as much anymore. You're just trying to get into the feel of the system just for next year. And then the Saints are going to beat you because they're fighting for a playoff seeding. So that is what I'm saying you are. Now, let's go with your floor. How much worse could you get? Pretty bad, actually. Pretty bad. Your floor is 0-16. But you're not going 0-16. I feel pretty good about where I had you at. Which one am I? This one. So now your ceiling's a lot better. 11-5. I could absolutely see this. I could 100% see you going 11-5, making the playoffs. But you'd have to really, really surprise everybody. New system, the way the offseason has been, I just don't see it. So, that is what I'm saying for the Carolina Panthers. That is the final NFC South prediction. So let me know what you think in the comments below, and I will see you in the next one.